A blind man's date. I sit quietly, in patient tryst, as I inhale joyous, insentient sticks, burning round circles of mystic charm and awaiting that faint, sweet, aromatic aroma of a quaint French red wine godsend to quench my stifling thirst. And here I fidget and shuffle in my firm seat of disbelief and impatience. And the warm candlelight placed delicately beside my round corner table glows quietly, romantically upon the soft laced embroidered cloth draped in some ethereal soothing color, or white for all it matters, forming an enigmatic round halo across in a clear glistening sheen. And within it I see, lucidly, a frail outline of perhaps a lovely smile. I hear some faint music too, from far across the street, of a mellifluous, sonorous refrain, perhaps an aching flute, in search of a lonely listener serving time. And all of this seemed to match suddenly, definitively, with the sound of fleeting feet running nimbly towards me or upon the far cobblestones of some carefree street urchins in a heavenly duet of togetherness. And I keep waiting patiently for the soft touch of her arrival.